What's up, guys? Devin here from American Aquarium. How you doing? Hey, check out my shirt today. You guys like it? DC Comics. What kind of comics do you guys like? You know what you also do? You guys remind me that I need to trim my beard hair by doing these videos. I look and I go, man, my beard's getting kind of long. I'm just playing. Having some fun. Okay, so the question of the day today is, how do we manage a cloudy, gray, white bacterial bloom in an aquarium? Seems to be a sought-after question, so I'm gonna go ahead and hit it with what we have. This is the 8 things that could cause the cloudy tank and how to correct them. Okay, so let's go over them real quick. So these white or gray tanks are gonna be caused by bacterial blooms that are heterotrophic. First reason can be that it has a poor cycle. It's most likely a new aquarium, or that there's an excess of these undesirable heterotrophic bacteria. Remember, everything in an aquarium is balanced. So when we have a more mature tank, the balance is a lot more stable. But when it's a new tank, this thing is out of whack and these bacteria will take over. That's your first one. Second one, second culprit is overfeeding. It's easy to do. And a lot of these foods have actually a very high amount of energies and proteins packed into them. So we just throw these things in there. And if we're not controlling our feeding, even if we think we're limiting the amount we're giving, boom, you're already overfeeding. Okay? Poor filtration. You'll see how all these things, kind of like, even though there's 8 things, they're going to be kind of similar, just a little bit different way of thinking about it. And then this will help you diagnose where your weak spot is and how to fix it. So poor filtration. Do you have a good amount of aerobic filtration? Do you have lots of pored surfaces in a filter, not just maybe a bio-wheel that's turning and you got a large tank and it's trying to maintain that whole thing? That's a big culprit. Poor circulation, which results in low oxygen. You need a high amount of aeration, which is going to be from your circulation, whether it be from a circulation pump, a power head, an air pump, all these things combined to a movement in the tank. Consider what you're trying to keep, the flow that you need, and adjust accordingly. I also have a neat video called Power Head versus Air Pump, depending on what you need. And I'll maybe put a link of that in the description. I don't know, I'll put like an annotation, get new use to those annotations. Okay, are you overcrowding your fish tank? Do you have too much bio load in there? Is there too much to handle the filter that your filter cannot handle? Got it? Poor water parameters. Always check your water parameters. That's the first go-to when you're trying to figure out these things. And lots of times it could be that it's a poor parameter. And then this would also be seen, I wouldn't say just new tanks, but there are times when our tanks get out of whack and the parameters are messed up. So we're looking for a 0 ammonia, or at least under 0.25 ammonia, and 0 nitrite. Okay, take a look at the nitrogen cycle, the chemistry article, and the redox balance article in the description below. And that redox is going to be lack of healthy oxidations that could lead to a cloudy aquarium. Too high of a bio load. So now we're not just talking fish, we're talking everything that could be in the tank, and it's just not having a good filter. Is there decaying plants in there? Is there an excess of food in there? Is there a bunch of snails in there? Anything, everything adds up to bio load. Poor bio load can have too many causes, such as poor filtration, poor cleaning procedures, too many fish, overfeeding, and it's basically a summary of all the above things that we just talked about. Overpopulation of detritus worms. Make sure you're talking about detritus worms and not planaria. There is a difference, which is a result from decaying matter, low oxygen content. There's a reference in the description below. Cool? Here's your corrective matters. Make sure you're doing a 20% water change every day until it improves. Boom, that's your first one. Increase circulation, aeration. The more surface area that you have and the more that's being broken, the more oxygen is gonna get in the water. And most of the times when we were on our service route, when we saw this issue, it was because there was like a weird size tank, maybe like a hexagon tank, and those more times than any other tank would have this cloudy issue. Okay, make sure you read the article about cycling and how to take correct measures of adding the correct amount of media and how to make an established aquarium, your substrate, all that plays a role. Cool? Consider a product called SeaChem Stability. Highly recommend it. We did a study against this one and Fritzheim Turbo Start. And it's just a good cycle aid that helps both aerobic and anaerobic bacteria and new tank ponds with a blend of synergistic of aerobic, which means encapsulating oxygen, and facilitative bacteria. As well, stability is helpful to aid in other sudden increases in bio load with an established aquarium. Cut back on feeding and improve the quality of food and the method amount. Remember how I always said some of these foods are like, they're real dense and they're just like packed full. You could improve the food that you're actually feeding, which is gonna give you a cleaner biosystem all around and not have these issues on your filter. Leads to less waste. Consider adding more filters such as the AAP hydra sponge. If you guys don't have a sponge somewhere in your tank with these real dense pores that are real like fine and get way back in there, I highly recommend them. They're a super efficient filter and they will outcompete any other filter any other day. Period. Boom. Done. Okay. And consider removing some fish if you need to. Lower the overall bio load. That's common sense. Here's a good one. Add a UV sterilizer. This is a very good alternative. It's not, you could just say, boom, skip all this stuff, add a UV sterilizer. This actually will help the overall system, but you do want to try to figure out where the problem is going wrong. If you're not wanting to take that time, a UV sterilizer, and I keep saying sterilizer, don't just go for a clarifier. Get one that's going to benefit the whole overall tank, the fish's immune system, protect them against disease. That's best. Not just a clarifier. If you need information about that, of course we have information about UV sterilization. That's what we do. Okay, so consider that. Make sure your ammonia and nitrate are at zero. Your GH is at least 100, depending on fish, of course, and that your nitrates are below 40, of course, depending on what kind of aquarium you're keeping. You need that GH, by the way, guys, so don't think that you need a low GH, because this is going to be your source of electrolytes that's going to improve your redox balance, which this is all going to help overall. And it's going to help the fish have a high immunity due to good osmoregulation. Consider argon as a natural control of these pollutants. Okay. If the cloud is a result of heterotrophic bacteria caused by overcrowding or especially decomposition of rotting food, excess waste, or dead fish, or the aquatic inhabitants that were not removed in a timely manner, that's when you'd want to consider all gone. Okay, you could use the potassium permanganate as a quick but temporary solution. Follow directions on that, of course. Consider that you have to have a strong cycle still, but I mean, if that's not where your problem is, but then you also want to say that this is just gonna be a band-aid and that you really want to find the cause. Don't use this all the time, but you could use it. It's a strong oxidizer. Okay. Sometimes this can happen in a very well-established aquarium after cleaning, because the particulates get in the water and just muck it up, and that is it's just gonna feed that bacteria, make the problem. So consider something like crystal clear. Do not recommend that in a new aquarium, but this is for established aquariums. Okay? All right, so that's the 8 things to why you might have a cloudy tank and how to correct them. Hope you guys liked it. I appreciate you. Tell me what your favorite DC character is. I actually like Marvel, but I got this one, and the kids like it, so I'm going to spoil it for today. All right, I appreciate you guys. Remember, like, subscribe, share. Please help me get these videos out. Talk to you next time. Bye.